Under the car, locate your exhaust downpipe. If you have a catalytic converter, the downstream O2 sensor will generally be mounted in the middle of the cat. I have a custom catless downpipe and the O2 sensor is connected to a 90-degree spacer. Please ignore my temporary conduit solution of wrapping these loose wires in a spare hose and just zip-tying it out of the way. To remove the O2 sensor, you will either want an O2 sensor socket, which I showed in my upstream O2 sensor replacement video, or you can just use a wrench. Again, this current O2 sensor was a used part that I temporarily installed for troubleshooting a check engine light. That is also why the wires are only held together with twist connectors. If you're removing a stock O2 sensor, there will be a plastic wiring connector in this location that unclips. Because I'm installing a universal O2 sensor, I'm cutting the wires, but leaving a few inches so I can identify which wires are which. With the wires disconnected, you can now remove the O2 sensor. This connector is for the upstream O2 sensor, and this branch of wiring leads to the downstream sensor. It is routed up along the back side of the exhaust heat shield and held in place with some plastic rivets. I've only pulled this wiring out for the ease of filming this video, otherwise this would be an unnecessary step. The brown, red, and green-yellow wires are for the heater circuit, and these connect to the white wires on the O2 sensor. Either white wire, it does not matter. The white, red, and brown, red wires, twisted together, are for the O2 signal. White, red connects to the black wire on the O2 sensor. Brown, red connects to the gray wire on the O2 sensor. This Bosch universal kit includes the same Bosch sensor that Volvo uses from the factory, but it costs a fraction of the price of the genuine Volvo part because it comes with a universal connector. These connectors are fairly straightforward. Feed in the connector base, strip the wires back about 1 centimeter, feed through the watertight seal. This probably would have been easier before I stripped the wires back. Feed the wire through the gray connector, then secure it all by screwing it into the other gray connector. Repeat this for all the wires on both ends. Be certain that you align the wires into the correct holes on the connector. With that all finished, I fed this back along the firewall and to the O2 bung. Because the wiring is already connected, I'm twisting the O2 sensor counterclockwise prior to installing it in the bung. As I screw the sensor in place, this undoes those twists that I just made, leaving the wires untwisted once finally installed. Do not over-tighten the O2 sensor. The wiring tension will prevent it from backing out, and this will allow for easier removal the next time the sensor must be replaced. Wrap the exposed wires in heat wrap and zip tie it up and out of the way so that it does not snag on any road debris or make contact with the exhaust pipe or drive shaft.